Hi, good morning children. Okay. Today we are going to learn about the same continuation version of the last chapter. Okay, last chapter, which is that? Yes, it is democracy in the contemporary world. Okay, yes, fine children. So democracy in the contemporary world, we have already learnt about the few concepts. Okay. You just re-glance whatever you have learnt. Okay. We have already learned about the story of country Chile and then the story of Poland. Along with it, the next, you know, we just compared between the Chile and the Poland and the democracy, the features of democracy also we have learnt. And next we have learnt about the expansion or phases of the expansion of this democracy. Okay, so yesterday in that phase, the beginning, that is the early stage, how it has started, the idea of democracy started in the mind of people all over the world. We have seen that. And next we saw that end of colonialism. So even we know that India was also one of the colony for British people. So how it came to an end? After the Second World War, many countries started to become independent. Understand? So there we can see that the maximum, you know, the end of colonialism. So today we are going to learn about the recent phase or the recent era, how it is happening, how democracy is carrying forward. Okay? Yes. See, today we are going to discuss about the phases in the expansion of democracy, that is the recent phase. Already we have learnt about the two phases. One it is the beginning and the one more it is the end of colonialism. Today we'll be learning about the recent phase. In that we'll be learning about, you know, the USSR, that is the Soviet Union, and about our, you know, neighboring countries, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Nepal and Myanmar. And then we'll go for recapitulation. Okay. Yes. Children, listen carefully. These are all the very important concepts. Okay. First, we see about the recent phase. See, after this end of the colonialism, once the colonialism got end, see, the big push towards democracy came after 1980 as democracy was revived in several countries of Latin America. So finally what happened? You know, this democracy, the idea of democracy started to expand more and more around after the 1980. And, you know, the many countries in Latin America and all, they started to restore or they started to bring back the administration, that is democracy as their government. Okay guys, so after 1980, the many countries started to adopt this democracy. This is a map of, you know, the Latin America. Yes children, so many countries started to adopt this, you know, democracy. What makes them to adopt all of a sudden? See here, the disintegration of the Soviet Union accelerated to bring back the democracy. So finally, we have learnt about the Soviet Union. Where? Guys, do you remember? In the story of Poland, we have learnt. So in Poland, what happened? Those people are the Soviet Union was supporting for military corps. And many other communist countries also. Okay, even Soviet Union was a communist, you know, the government they were following. It was supporting many other neighboring communist, you know, the countries. Okay. So once it started disintegrated, so that makes many countries to follow this democracy. Okay. See here. From the story of Poland, we know that the then Soviet Union controlled many of its neighboring communist countries in Eastern Europe. So in the Eastern Europe, in the European continent, Eastern Europe, maximum countries were under the control of this Soviet Union. Okay, the communist countries, the neighboring communist countries and all was under the control of this Soviet Union or USSR. Once it got disintegrated, then it leads to the many countries to adopt democracy. Okay guys, see here, you can see this. No, this is USSR. It had controlled the many other neighboring countries. In red color, you can see that all are communist countries. Okay, so here in the newspaper, you can see that the USSR passes into history. So finally, it got disintegrated. Yes, children, we'll see the next one. It is Poland and several other countries became free from the control of the Soviet Union during 1989 and 90. So finally, we knew that even Poland was under the control of Soviet Union. Like Soviet, you know, the Poland, many other countries also became free or became independent. Okay, during 1989 to 1990. So the countries which became independent, those countries started to adopt democracy as their government. Okay, once they got independent, they started to follow or they started to choose democracy as their government. In that Soviet Union or USSR, it comprised almost 15 republics. So in the last map, you people saw that. See, it has comprised so many, that is the 15 republics. Finally, once the USSR or the Soviet Union, you know, divided or disintegrated, then we can see almost 15 republics started to make its independent countries. Okay, children, it make 15 independent countries, that is republics. Then all those 15 countries started to adopt democracy as their government. Guys, are you all understanding, right? So hope you are understanding this concept. Understood, right? Finally, once this Soviet Union disintegrated, then it leads many countries to follow democracy. They became freedom or independent. So once they got independent, once they became independent, then they started to adopt democracy as their government. Okay, this Soviet Union comprised 15 republics. Okay, let us see in the next. Yes, see, all the constituent republics emerged as the independent countries. So finally, all those 15 republics and all, they started to emerge as a independent country. They are not again emerging as a Soviet Union. They became independent. Okay, children, see, most of them became democracies. So as I told you people, once they got independent, once, you know, the each country became independent, then they started to adopt democracy as their government. Thus, the end of Soviet control on East Europe and the breakup of the Soviet Union led to a big change in the political map of the world. So finally, once the Soviet Union or the Soviet control, the communist administration came to an end in East Europe. So that led many countries to follow, yes, that is democracy. So finally, once the many countries started to adopt democracy, we can see the change in our political map of the world. Okay, so we can see many countries started to adopt democracy as their government. Okay, children, hope you guys understood about Soviet Union. Yes, children. Next, we'll see about our neighboring country, Pakistan. So how Pakistan started to follow democracy and again how it has been overthrown by the military cause. So when we were discussing yesterday, I told you people the situation, how people are struggling even now, and even how people were struggling also. So what happens in many countries, even though they were following democracy, it was not a complete democracy. Okay, as I told you people, it was a partial democratic government they were following. That means all the adults were not given right to vote. Okay, so once the people started to follow this universal adult franchise. Guys, what is universal adult franchise? Just take a glance. Yes, children, you people are correct. Universal adult franchise means, you know, all the citizens, all the adult citizens of the country have got right to vote, irrespective of their caste, irrespective of their gender, irrespective of their status, and all those things. Okay, so coming to the Pakistan, what was the situation? Let us see now. See, Pakistan and Bangladesh made a transition from army rule to democracy in 1990s. So here they are telling our neighboring countries, that is Pakistan and the Bangladesh, they made a transition, that is they changed from dictatorship, that is army rule, to democracy in 1990s. So even yesterday also we discussed, do you people remember that? Even many countries adopted democracy, but that democracy did not stay for longer time. Okay, even the same situation we can see in Pakistan also. So in the 1990s, they started to follow democracy from the army rule, that is what we call it as a dictatorship. But see here, in the 1999, General Mushraf brought back army rule. So as we discussed yesterday, children, what happened? In many countries, earlierly they started to adopt democracy, but later again it was overthrown by some other form of government. It may be like a dictatorship or monarchy or some other thing. So same here also in Pakistan, they adopted this democracy, and the democracy overthrown by again army rule in the year of 1999. But finally in the year of 2008, it became democratic. Okay, so finally in the year of 2008, Pakistan also started to follow democracy. Guys, understood about Pakistan, right? Are you all clear with this concept? Very good, children. We'll move on to the next one. Yes. So this is also one of our neighboring country. So recent issues are going on with this country. So do you people remember, or are you people aware about this? Yes, children, this is very much necessary that you people should know what is happening in our country, to our country, neighboring countries. Okay, so now that border issues are going on. Okay, so we'll see how Nepal started to follow democracy and whether still it is following the democracy or not. Okay, let's see, children. In Nepal, the king gave up many of his powers to become a constitutional monarch to be guided by elected leaders. So here what happens in Nepal, you know, the king around in the 1980s only. So they also started with the, you know, 1990s and all, they started with the idea even to adopt democracy even in Nepal. So that is the reason the king gave many of his powers. Okay, he just left many of his, you know, the powers just to make the country as a constitutional monarchy. Okay,